this first video, an avid cave explorer on YouTube known by the channel name Exploring Abandoned Mines and Unusual Places is exploring an abandoned mine for the simple purpose of reviewing a flashlight. During the video, you can hear as the explorer goes into detail about the flashlight and demonstrates its use in the mine he's exploring. However, while talking to the camera about both the mine and the flashlight he's reviewing, the explorer hears what he first thinks to be wind blowing through the mine. Though many believe the audio sounds like a very disturbing whispering or talking sound.
Okay, this is a review and demonstration of the Thru-Night TN12 handheld flashlight that you see here. Okay, that's the portal to the Waldeck mine. I'm inside. The wind has kind of died down a little bit and it's not raining, so I managed to stay dry. Of course, I'm inside this little alcove, kind of, but anyway, you come down this little incline path, and then big boulders here you have to climb over, and then the tunnel's right behind me this way. So let's check it out. Let's get in here. And like I said, this light has five levels. I believe it's on medium right now, which is level 3, so this would be high, and this would be turbo, which is really bright. And then this is Firefly, which is hardly anything. And then that would be low. And then medium. Medium seems to be the best one. Not too bright, not too dim. And then you can see how big these timbers are. That's about almost a foot in diameter, the big cross timber. So they had to put big ones in here to hold up all of this rock. And you can see right here where some of these boards are bending. Do you hear that? Sounds like, what is that, wind? I don't know if you can hear that on the camera. Do you hear that? It stopped. Well, I don't know what that is. That doesn't sound like wind, but that's crazy. Don't know if that's a bird or I don't know what that is. It almost sounds like snakes, but wow. I've heard some weird stuff in mines, but that is definitely creepy. I don't know what that is. So let's get out of here and head back out to the portal. That was weird.
These next two videos come from the same Exploring YouTube channel shown earlier. This time, however, the explorer visits an abandoned, supposedly haunted mine in Nevada known as Horton Mine. The first time he visits, he claims to feel negative energy coming from the mine, and what he witnesses goes to support his claim. However, with the popularity of the first visit, the YouTuber decides to visit the abandoned mine a second time, this time hearing something very disturbing. Here are both of those visits to the mine.
Okay, here's a lower adit at the Victorine mine. I believe this was an older mine that once they dug the upper tunnels, this got incorporated into the same claim or whatever. Okay, we can go in here and just take a quick look. I don't think I'm gonna explore this particular mine. There's a little bit too much water in here, and I know this mine is really old, but yeah, water in a mine. I do see other footprints here in the mud. But I just don't think it's wise to go in here when there's water. Try to avoid this if I can. Yeah, this looks pretty sketchy. I'll go a few feet further in and check it out, but I think I'm gonna pass on this one. This is one of the creepiest mine tunnels I've ever been in, just because of how dilapidated it is and all these chains hanging down from the overhead, and there's a shot looking down the tunnel. Here's a shot looking back towards the entrance. I'm a little bit further in. And looking down the tunnel here. I don't know why that one chain is swinging back there. Don't know if you can see that in the video or not. Yeah, this mine definitely has a very spooky vibe to it. So I'm gonna head back out and check out the other stuff that's here. This is just too wet, too muddy. And obviously something is making the chains swing. So time to get the hell out of here. Okay, the Horton mine still has some water coming out of it. You can see it kind of pooled up here outside, and here's the portal. So let's go check this out, see if it's any drier than it was a year ago when I was last here. Okay, I'm further in than I was a year ago, and that's how far I've come. Okay, here's a final parting shot of the end of the Horton Tunnel. And there's the ore pass with all the cascading water. And what the fuck is that? I don't know what that was, but there was a sudden blast of cold air, and I'm getting out of here.
A man named Clem Schultz and his wife lived in Fairdale, Illinois during one of the most destructive tornadoes in the history of Fairdale. During the storm, Clem took a video from the top floor of his house as he saw the giant tornado get closer. Clem thought the tornado would miss his house, when in fact it was coming directly towards him, all while he was still recording. Unfortunately, Clem's wife would pass away because of the intensity of the tornado, while Clem would receive a terrible spine injury. The phone he took the video on was later discovered in the rubble of his home, and this is what the video was able to capture. This next video shows a man exploring the Paris Catacombs, which is a place very well known for causing people to get lost. They are essentially the most complex series of tunnels in the world, definitely not somewhere you'd want to find yourself exploring without experience. The video shows this man getting lost and going into a full panic run as he doesn't know where to go to get out. The man was never found, but his camera later was, with no trace of the guy.
It's very bizarre. These arrows point in a direction. Occasionally also, he stops to photograph roomfuls of bones, which means that he's very, very deep inside the catacombs. So basically, he's filming what he's seeing very deep inside the catacombs, other than the point of view shots, or pictures of human bones. The catacombs for centuries. So it is possible with these paintings that we may be able to retrace his itinerary to some extent. After about four, we hear his breathing get louder and louder, as though something was scaring him. He's frightened. Occasionally he stops, perhaps to try to decide which way to run among all the many different corridors. He's running faster and faster and faster, deeper and deeper into the catacombs. And all of a sudden, we hear his breathing get louder and louder, as though something was scaring him. He's frightened. Occasionally he stops, perhaps to try to decide which way to run among all the many different corridors. He's running faster and faster and faster, deeper and deeper into the catacombs. And all of a sudden,